Hello everyone, and thank you for joining. My name is Valerii Svydenko, and I'm going to present you how to customize your own online IDE with a Devfile. So in this talk, I'm going to explain you what is Eclipse Che, which components it has. Then we'll see what is Devfile and which structure does it have. Also, I want to demonstrate you a small demo where I will change existing Devfile inside Eclipse IDE, Eclipse Che, to work with Quarkus samples. Of course, I will say a few words about Quarkus, explain what is it. In the end, we will see some benefits of Devfile, why it's good to use it. And of course, we'll have some time for questions in the end. So about Eclipse Che. Eclipse Che is Kubernetes native IDE for developer teams. And it provides Kubernetes native workspaces. Workspaces inside Che are Kubernetes pods, and everything has been containerized. I mean, editors, plugins, tools, environments, all are working inside containers. And you can bring your runtime applications inside your workspace. The editor, which is packaged by default in Eclipse Che, is based on Eclipse Teia. We do that to provide VS Code-like experience. There is built-in support for language server protocol and for debug adapter protocol. Also, there is compatibility with VS Code extensions. But in Che, it's also easy to swap your editor. It's also possible to use, for example, Eclipse Dirigible or Jupyter Notebook or even Eclipse IDE. All you can bring inside the workspace. Che also has two registries. The first one is plugin registry, and the second one is Devfile registry. In Devfile registry, you register your Devfiles, and Che already has own Devfile registry where we have Devfiles for Python, C Sharp, Go, Java, Node.js, C++, and each Devfile reference plugins which are living in plugin registry. Che plugin is like YAML file, and it wraps VS Code extension or Teia plugin, and one Che plugin can contain more than one VS Code extension. For example, Java Che Java plugin contains two VS Code extensions. The first one is Java language server to support Java language, and the second one is Java debugger, which is provided by Microsoft to debug Java applications. So Devfiles are living in Devfile registry, and on the left you can see general structure of Devfile. So what is Devfile? Devfile is a YAML file that describes and defines developer environment in Che. So here you can specify the structure of your environment. And it contains three general parts, blocks. The first one is project. It's where you can specify your project repository, project source repository. This part is optional. I mean, if you don't want to clone some project in your workspace when it will be started, you can just skip this part and your workspace will be empty without any projects. The second part is components. Components could have different types. For example, it could be editor, editor components includes editor and it describes the container where editor is running. It could be Cheteya or another editors which I show. Another type of components is plugin. It's the component where you can include some VS Code extension or another plugins, Teya plugin. And this plugin should be like Che plugin. And one more type of components is environment. It could be build, test, or runtime. It depends what you need to do in your workspace. For example, one runtime you need to build your application, another one for testing, I mean to run some tests, and one more to run the application. The last part of the devfile is commands that you want to bring inside your workspace. It also could be a command to run the application or build or debug, or some command that you or your team usually do when develop the application. Let's see a few examples of the file. This one is the simplest one. As you can see, it contains just three lines, but using this devfile, you can create your workspace and it will contain just editor where you can create file and write some message text. But it works, you can just use it and create new workspace. Another one example is describes developer environment to work with C# applications. It contains one project which will be cloned after starting the workspace. Also, it contains two components. The first one is Che plugin, which provides Che OmniSharp plugin to work with C# language, to providing some support for language. And another component is developer environment. It needs to build the application and run it. On the right side, we can see commands which our devfile contains. There are three commands. The first one is to update dependencies, and the second to run, and the last one to build the application. And all these commands should be run inside the environment. So let's talk now more about structure of the file. I'm going to explain each attribute which could be included to the file, and I will start with required attributes. The first one is API version. This attribute is required, and it describes how you specify which API version you use for the files. Right now, Che supports just one version, it's 1.0.0. Another required attribute is metadata. It describes, it could contain attribute name or generate name. If you put name, it means that when you create some workspace from this devfile, it will have, the workspace will have name with this value. If you add generate name instead of name, you can create many workspaces. Each workspace will have name which starts with this prefix. The next attribute is projects, and it's optional and tells the workspace where to find the project that will be cloned, will be included in your space. In this case, we are pointing some one projects from GitHub repository. We can put the name for this project, and we can see this name inside our project tree in IDE. Also, we point in some GitHub repository, and this project can have type Git. Also, it could be possible to put value as zip file and write location to file on your local system. And one another attribute for type Git is it could be sparse checkout gear. It could be useful when some repository contains many sub-projects and you want to clone just one project. You can specify this attribute and put the name of that sub-project. The next part is attributes. This part is optional, and here you can pretty much specify anything you wish. In that case, we have persist while in false, and we need that to make our workspace works quickly. It means that ephemeral mode is activated, and in ephemeral mode, workspaces has no persisted volumes. The next component is the biggest one, I would say, is the next attribute, is components. Components could have, each component could have a different type, and it depends on which type it has. It can have different set of other attributes. For example, each component could have type Docker image, Che plugin, Che editor, or Kubernetes, or even OpenShift. If a component has type Che plugin, it should contain ID. ID is an identifier to plugin registry where plugins are living. If the plugin doesn't live in Che plugin registry, you can add instead of ID reference and point some URL to raw file where the plugin is living. Another attribute is alias. It's name using which other places of this dev file, for example commands, can refer to this command. This attribute is optional but must be unique in the dev file. Another attribute is mount sources, and if it has value true, it makes that source code available in that container. So if we describe some developer environment or runtime environment, we usually specify the type as Docker image, and this component should have image attribute which specifies a Docker image that should be used in that container. But usually we use community images, but we need to a bit specify this image for OpenShift specific technology. For example, set some permissions to home directory to allow arbitrary users to write something into that. Also, it could be possible to add some command to make our image always active. Another attribute which you can see here is endpoints. And endpoints describes Docker image component endpoints with name and port. And the user will have an action inside IDE to click on that endpoint and open a tab with another tab in browser. And also, it is possible to define volumes. Volumes defines a directory within the workspace, within the container that is available to this workspace. And it could be useful for example, for dependencies to avoid each time downloading the dependencies when you build the project. Another part is commands. In this section, you can define custom command that will be available for you inside your workspace. Typically, it's just a command line which will be executed in terminal. But inside IDE, we will see them like buttons or where we can just click and execute that command. Each command has name, which will be displayed inside IDE, and actions. Right now, Che supports just one action for each command. But in action, you can describe type, a command line, component where this command should be executed, and working directory for sources where this should be executed. Also, it is possible to define type as VS Code launch, except of instead of exec. It means that you want to describe debug configuration, which will be added into launch's own file. And by using this debug configuration, you can use your debugger to debug the application. So that's it about the structure. And Right now, I'm going to go to the demo, and in the demo, I'm going to open hosted Che. It's che.openshift.io, and I'm going to create the workspace from existing Devfile, and will modify it, because as for me, it's better to create your Devfile inside Che, because we already have some content which we can modify. We can see existing plugins which provides Che plugin registry. Also in Eclipse Che we have a nice editor where we can edit, where we can use auto-completion. It's Monaco editor which also provides YAML language server. So for demo, let's imagine I'm new in Quarkus world. Quarkus, it's cloud native stack for writing Java microservices and serverless applications. And it's just to be quick. And it's really popular now because it provides hot redeploy for Java applications, and it also provides native compilation. So let's imagine I want to start learn about Quarkus. I want to follow some tutorial from Quarkus.io, and for this I need to build my own developer environment. So I'm thinking what I need to work with Quarkus. At least I need to have Maven and Java version 8 or 11 or higher. So let's open our IDE. This is Eclipse Che. It's how dashboard looks like. Here we have a stack of the files. They come from the file registry. So I want to choose one Devfile which already contains Java and Maven, for example, Java Vertex, and go to editing it. What I can see here? Here I have several tabs, for example, plugins tab, where I can see plugins from plugin registry, and I can just activate or deactivate some plugin. If I know that some plugin already is here, I can just activate it and use it. Also, I have the Devfile tab with Monaco editor, and here I can modify my Devfile to adapt to my work. So let's start modify it. Let's change the name. Let's go to projects. And here I should describe the source code of my project. I know that Quarkus.io provides some repository with his tutorial. It's getting started guides. And I just want to clone the rel, copy rel, and put it as a location. It's here, it's have type git, and also I don't want to clone all projects. I just want to start doing this tutorial. It's getting started. Let's go to source section and add. As you can see, I can use autocompletion and use pass checkout dir with this value. Okay, now let's save it. Actually, I can modify each component step by step and check it by running the workspace and check if everything works. But to save our time, I just want to continue editing this Devfile, and we'll start it in the end. So persistent volumes is okay for us to make it work more quickly. Next, go to components. The first component describes Che Java plugin, which provides Java language server and Java debugger, but I also know that VS Code has extension for Quarkus, and I want to use it in my SMI plugin. I can build my own Che plugin. For example, I have this plugin here. As you can see, in the end, in that YAML file, I have three VS Code extensions. It's VS Code Java Debug, Java Language Server, and VS Code Quarkus. Now I just want to copy URL to raw file and put it as a reference of my Che plugin. Let's save it. Okay, now let's go to another component. It describes developer environment. I already selected that the file which contains that environment, I mean, which provides Java 8. As you can see here, you can description of image, it's such a Java 8 with Maven. And it will work for me because for starting, I just need to have Java and Maven in my container. Also, as you can see, we have an attribute which injects some environment variables inside my container. This environment variable specifies some configuration for Maven and Java, so I can proceed with them. Next, let's go to commands. Which command I will need to work with my Quarkus application? Let's say the first one should be to build. Let's change the name. The action should have type exec. The command could be the same, or we can change it. My Maven clean install. The component value is Maven. It means that we should execute this command in that component which has alias Maven, as you can see here. Now we have to specify the working directory where this command should be executed. For specifying some commands, some working directories, we can use environment variables from our containers. Che project's root describes the root of our source code, but we have to change this part where our project is. It should be, let's change the name. Starts. Okay, see, thank you. Let's copy this. And what we need also to add subfolder. It's getting started, sub project. Yeah, good. Let's save it and see if everything is okay. Okay. Now let's add another command to run the application in development mode when we can debug our application. Okay, the working directory should be the same. We can just copy it. And the type is exec and command line. The command line should be Maven compile Quarkus dev. Okay, the component is Maven, it's okay, and we don't need another commands, let's just remove it. Also, here we have description of debug configuration which should be added into long.json. And this configuration describes a debugger to attach to remote Java process. And it will work for us because it's Java application. So let's save our dev file. Okay, and let's try it. Just open the workspace. Workspace is starting, and what is going here? Here we create Kubernetes pod, which we described in dev file, and it downloads, pull all images for all containers, and it will start all containers. And when the containers will be started, we will see our IDE. The editor is loading. Okay, we can see that our project is cloning and was cloned actually. Let's open project tree and we can see that our project is here. Let's open some Java file to start initializing Java language server. On the bottom you can see the process from Java language server. Now let's go to workspace view. In the workspace view, we can see what we generated in what we created in our dev file. Here we have runtime component which calls Maven. We have our two commands to build Quarkus application, to run it. Also we have endpoint which we will use a bit later. Also in plugins we have our VS Code Quarkus plugin. So now let's try to run some command. For example, let's run our application in development mode. Just click on the command and now we can see output that our application is building. I'm going to close this view. So now we can see that our application is running, and right now we can open this application inside our IDE to see how it looks like. Or we can go to workspace view and just click on endpoint, and we can see this application in another tab. So let's try how hot redeploy works. Let's create a local variable, for example. As you can see, I'm using features which Java language server provides. I can just execute extra to local variable. The name is okay, and just add something to... Now let's go to our browser and execute get request. It's hello. It should be hello, greeting, and some name. We can see the response, and now let's just change the value. It's Java code, and I want to show you how hot redeploy works. And just refresh our browser. So you can see we have our changes on the board. Now I want to debug this code. What I need, I just put some breakpoint here. Go to debugger view. Here I can open long.json where I can see my debug configuration which I added in the dev file. And let's just execute this debugger. Debugger is started. Now let's refresh the page to call this get method. And we are here. So now we can see here some variables. We can change, debug our application, or continue executing. What else I can see here? Also, I included Quarkus VS Code extension, and to check that it works, I can go to comments. And write some Quarkus. I see some comments which were provided by VS Code Quarkus extension. For example, let's execute Quarkus welcome, and we can see a welcome page from that extension. Probably that's it for demo. I go to back to dashboard. I can stop my workspace. I see that something works. I can go through the tutorial and work some tests, something to work. And if I finally create my dev file, I can just copy it from this editor and push in some local public place, for example, on the GitHub. As you can see, I have some dev file. It's the same dev file, and I can copy the raw URL to this dev file and build factory, which means it should be like Che host. It could be Che OpenShift IO. Then it should be F, which means factory, and pass param URL with value of link to my raw file. And I copy this link and send to my friend, and it just can reproduce the same workspace environment on his site. So right now, the new workspace is created, and it will have the same developer environment which I had. So let's go back to my presentation. So workspace is starting, and as a result, we'll have another one workspace in Che. So that's it about demo, and just what I have else, I want to point you some benefits which we have with the file. So first of all, it's easy to build your complex developer environment, just use some editor. And the second one is you can do that in each place where you are. So you don't need to download something, you can just open editor. I prefer to use Eclipse IDE because you can IDE because you can try it on the fly. You can edit, change something, and try it right now. Another point is that you can easily share this developer environment. You just copy the URL, send to somebody, and that's it. So. Probably that's it what I want to say. So right now you can see some links, useful links, where Eclipse Che is living. We have some dev list. Also we have recognized the documentation where you can find all description of all attributes in the file. Also, you can find how to create it, how to share, and another useful information. Also, we have Mattermost channel to ask questions and the link when you where you can try build your own developer environment. So now time for questions. Okay, the question is, what is the limitation for using? If we are talking about Che OpenShift I/O, it's limited by 3 gigs of RAM. But you can deploy your Eclipse Che as a local in local environment as to Minikube or Minishift or Circe, and you can use how much you have on your local machine.
By the way, there is a discussion to increase RAM, so to make it more than 3 gigabytes. So stay tuned, and we will update the terms of service very likely, because 3 gigs is good for getting started, but we want also to provide something more.
But is this limit because of some commercial, like is the bigger license, or is it just?
No. It's just dollar problem because you have to pay for RAM.
Yeah, sure.
And we want to provide free of charge, not free, but a little bit more. So it's under discussion now. Just.
Yeah. I have a question. Are you dog fooding? Are you developing Eclipse Che itself using Eclipse Che?
Yeah, when I need to provide new dev file, for example, if I need to provide new dev file to the file registry, I use Eclipse Che to create it because it's easiest way, because you can write and you can see that everything is wrong, and you can add something new, try it again, go back to dashboard, editing, try it again, and then when you got final result, you just put it into repository and that's it. The question is why this workspace will be created, as I understand. Yeah, if I want to share my developer environment,
exactly. And
so the workspace will be created in this namespace where I created my own dev file. So if it's multi-user, you can just send it, and user will be created in its own namespace. Yeah.
Is there any support or maybe a plans for offline work? For example, you have a server deployed or publicly or in the premise with OpenShift and Che, and then you need to go to the meeting, meet someone, and then you don't have a connection, or what's that?
If you use hosted, the question is what happened if I got some problems with this connection, yeah?
Yeah, I'm asking about because, for example, Gmail has an offline mode, so you can use it, you can, for some level of degree, but at least you can browse some things that you are already downloaded to your local browser.
Yeah, so if you use hosted here, and you have some unsaved changes, so it's probably it will be a problem because it will be lost. And but you can have Eclipse Che as a local deployment, and then your changes will be on your laptop. But for hosted Che, if it's has ephemeral mode, if you don't push your changes, everything will be lost.
I don't talk about pushing, I'm just talking about browsing. Yeah. So for example, someone is writing an app and then goes to the client for a presentation and want to talk about it and browse the code, show something about that, and Is it possible, or he needs a connection to do that?
If you need the connection to show your work, so if it's on hosted share, you won't have an ability to open it because it's on the internet. Well, you have to have connection. But you can present it and use share deployed on your local Kubernetes cluster, Minishift or Minikube, and demonstrate it without connection. If you pull all images, because to start the DevOps space, you need to pull images from the internet.
Yeah,
if you pull it before, you can use it locally. Yeah.
Maybe a similar question. So if I start creating the project in OpenShift or on the internet hosted somewhere, so I can synchronize it locally and just use the local installation, like you said, with Minikube or something. You have it locally also, the same project, which also is online, right?
The question is if it's possible to synchronize from different instances, for example, from hosted share to local Minikube deployment. You can do that by changing your devfile, and in that devfile you need to point on some repository which you used in hosted share. You need a bit customize your devfile to port everything that you want. Also, it's possible to use factory. If your devfile is on some GitHub repository, you can build the factory, which I showed how to. You can put Che host on your local deployment, and then put F and URL to raw file of your devfile, and it will be represented in your local deployment. Another questions?
Also a related question. So let's imagine a scenario where I'm connected to the internet by Wi-Fi and I'm happily coding in Eclipse Che, but then suddenly the Wi-Fi goes down. Am I still able to edit the file and do my coding? And after 2 minutes, when the Wi-Fi is working again, does it synchronize? Or am I still able to edit code when suddenly internet goes off?
The content will be on your computer, but if you click save button, you lost your content because it won't be saved, and the content in the file will be goes back, which is on the cloud, and your changes won't be here. Yeah, it's possible to use autosave, but as for me, it's not really useful because when I try to type in something to add, it every time tries to autosave, and it can be a bit noisy.
I also saw that there are some predefined stacks available, like with Quarkus, Java with Maven, Java with Gradle. If I would like to contribute a different stack, Java related, where would be the place to open up a request?
So the question is if it's possible to contribute and where I should put a pull request. So if you want to contribute to to the devfiles, share devfiles, you can open GitHub Eclipse Che devfile registry repository and just create a pull request with your devfile.
So the stacks are based on devfiles?
The stack of devfiles, which we saw on the dashboard, it came from devfile registry. So that stack is Che devfile registry. Other questions?
So
So thank you.